Many people along the way tell us that we should step down, you know, that we're too weak, that we can't do something, that, you know, a woman doesn't belong somewhere. But we really should kind of ignore it, because if we step down, our daughters will step down and their daughters will step down. And then we have a very negative chain of events. I'm Ina Braverman, founder and CEO of EcoWave Power. I really believe that the solution for the world's problem is incorporating all renewable energy sources. This is the only way of achieving a 100% clean planet. My message to the world would be, never give up on your dreams. Keep pursuing your true passion, because passion is the greatest renewable energy source. I'm Ina Braverman, founder and CEO of EcoWave Power. I established EcoWave Power at the year 2011, when I was 24, with the goal of commercializing wave energy. Wave energy is a very huge electricity source. According to the World Energy Council, it can produce twice the amount of electricity that the world produces now. That's why I'm very passionate about making wave energy happen. And I think also my passion for renewables comes from my personal story. I live in Israel, but I wasn't born here. I was born in Ukraine in 1986. And 2 weeks after I was born, the Chernobyl nuclear reactor exploded, which was the largest in history nuclear disaster in terms of costs and casualties. I was one of the babies that got hurt from the negative effects of the explosion. I actually had a respiratory arrest and a clinical death. And luckily my mother, who's a nurse, approached my crib on time and gave me a mouth-to-mouth resuscitation until the ambulance came and saved my life. So I got a second chance in life, and I really, really wanted to do something good with it. And I believe that EcoWave Power's mission of revolutionizing kind of the renewable energy sphere and of making wave energy a reality is definitely, you know, a good use of my second chance in life. In my opinion, the greatest challenge right now is bureaucratic challenges that lie in the fact that governments really want renewable energy, all kinds of renewable energies, but they still didn't legislate for innovative renewable energy sources. Basically, the energy that can be produced from the power of the waves is dependent on three factors. The first factor is the height of the waves. So the higher the waves are, the more electricity we will produce. The second is the period between one wave and another, like how many seconds are between one wave and another. So the shorter the period, the more energy we produce. And how much space do we have on the existing breakwater of installed capacity. However, kind of climate change and what we're doing to our world is right now in much larger magnitude than the Chernobyl nuclear reactor has ever been. Like, it didn't happen in one day. We kind of created this situation over many, many years of not taking care of the environment. But still, according to the World Health Association, 1 out of 7 people nowadays die premature death directly caused by pollution, directly caused by what we're doing to our environment. So it's killing much more people than Chernobyl ever did, and it's still not high enough on the agenda. So I think that there needs to be kind of more closing the gap between the discussions about climate change and about putting it high on the agenda to actual implementation of renewable energies. According to Ernest Young, only 5% of the executive in the energy industry are women, meaning 95% are men. That's definitely not enough women around the table. And as a young woman, you know, I opened the company, I was 24 years old. There's not a lot of young women or women at all in our sector. So every time I would go into the conference room excited about to present our innovative EcoWave Power technology, people would go, espresso please, water. They were sure if there's a woman in the room, she's probably there as somebody's assistant. Many people along the way tell us that we should step down, you know, that we're too weak, that we can't do something, that, you know, a woman doesn't belong somewhere. But we really should kind of ignore it, because if we step down, our daughters will step down and their daughters will step down. And then we have a very negative chain of events. I really believe that if what you're doing is your true passion, then you should pursue it, because passion is the greatest renewable energy source, even stronger than the power of the waves.